Alright, the best part of any Danganronpa game, the part that is the point of Danganronpa games, we will read all the truth bullets before we start each trial. The victim was Sayaka Maizono. The time of death is estimated to be around 1:30 a.m. The body was discovered in Makoto's room in the dormitory. The death took place in the bathroom. The cause of death was a stab wound to the abdomen, and her right wrist appears to have been fractured. Evidence of a struggle. There are a number of scratches and gouges on the bed and walls in Makoto's room. Replica sword. Makoto took this from the gym entryway and put it in his room. The sword was found out of its sheath on the floor in the middle of the room. The sword handle was missing and some of the gold coating, as was part of the blade. Replica sword sheath. Makoto took this from the gym entryway and put it in his room. The sheath was found some distance from the sword itself, and it shows evidence of being scratched with a sharp object. If you were going to attack someone with a sword, you would almost certainly remove the sheath first. Switching rooms. On the night of the murder, Makoto and Sayaka traded rooms and room keys. When the victim was discovered, Makoto's room key was found in Makoto's room. Sayaka had originally asked Makoto to switch with her when someone attempted to force their way into her room and she became frightened. Toolkit. This had been placed in Makoto's room before he arrived. It remained unopened and there is no evidence of it ever having been used. All the other male students claim that they haven't used theirs either, but still. Makoto's room's cleanliness. Not a single hair was found on the floor of the scene of the crime. In addition, the lint roller shows evidence of being used. Sayaka's wrist. Sayaka's wrist, right wrist, had been fractured, and her wrist was glittery at the injury's location. In addition, her hands appeared to be completely clean, except for the index finger on her left hand, which had some blood on it. Dying message. A series of numbers have been written in blood on Makoto's bathroom wall. 11037. It is assumed that Sayaka wrote these numbers while leaned up against the wall as she lay dying. Bathroom door frame. Makoto's bathroom door was difficult to open due to it not quite fitting in the door frame properly. The only two people who know the trick to opening are Makoto, the room's owner, and Sayaka, the victim. Bathroom doorknob. Makoto's bathroom doorknob had been broken. The screws holding it in place had all been partially or completely removed. Dorm nameplates. The nameplates on the doors to Sayaka and Makoto's rooms were apparently switched at some point. Kitchen knife set. The kitchen in the dining hall has a set of kitchen knives. Apparently, one of the knives had gone missing. Aoi's account. The knife from the kitchen went missing while Aoi was in the dining hall. Aoi swears that Makoto did not come to the dining hall at any point while she was there. Trash duty. There's apparently a trash room within the school. It's blocked off by a sturdy gate that can only be opened with trash room key. Incinerator. The incinerator can be activated via a switch on the machine. Hifumi was on cleaning duty, and he claims that the last time he saw the incinerator, it was off. However, when Makoto checked it after the incident, the incinerator was, in fact, on. The distance from the gate to the incinerator is roughly 30 feet. Burnt shirt piece. A piece of burnt clothing was found next to the incinerator in the trash room. It is apparently part of a shirt cuff, and it has a noticeable blood stain on it. Shattered crystal ball. Shards of glass were found next to the incinerator in the trash room. As it turns out, the glass ball would have fit comfortably in the palm of a person's hand. Apparently, Yasuhiro left the ball in the laundry room on accident, so anyone could have come along and taken it. We have two skills to set. Algorithm increases the speed of memorizing a statement, effective during the non-stop debate. And melodious voice. Increases damage to the opponent when a statement is destroyed. Effective during the bullet time battle. Good, because I'm terrible at bullet time battles.
Let's begin with a basic explanation of the class trial. So, your votes will determine the results. If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate.
And the killer really is one of us, right?
Of course!
Okay, then. Everyone, close your eyes. And whoever did it, raise your hand!
He's so precious!
Don't be a goddamn idiot. Why the hell would they raise their hand?
Before we move on and start the trial, can I ask a question real quick? What's going on with those pictures?
I'd feel awful if they got left out just because they died. Friendship penetrates even death's barrier.
Friendship
penetrates.
Okay, but what about that other empty seat? There were only 15 of us to begin with, so why are there 16 seats?
Oh, no reason. It's just that our little courtroom here can technically fit up to 16 people. Okay, that about does it for the preamble. Get ready to get started. First up is the case summary. Now, let the class trial begin.
It's about to begin, the debate to decide who we think the killer is. Anything I found, anything I noticed, I have to be ready to speak up about everything. Because this isn't just about me, everyone's lives are on the line. Your first non-stop debate is about to begin, would you like to hear more? As things progress during each class trial, you will engage in a number of non-stop debates. During these discussions, characters will speak one after another without pause. It is up to you to unearth any lies or contradictions buried within their statements. What this means is that you'll have to use your truth bullets to refute what they say. Any relevant truth bullets you've found during your investigation will be loaded into the truth cylinder. Use the left stick to aim, then fire with the Y button. Pay close attention to each character's statements and use your truth bullets to blast the right ones. Note that if you run out of time, you'll automatically fail, so please be careful. If you press the start button during these arguments, you can review the controls. Well then, good luck and have fun! This is easier to do with a mouse. But I do not use the mouse and keyboard, I only use controllers. Evidence of a struggle.
I assert that the one who was murdered was Miss Sayaka Maizono!
Yeah, we know that part already.
Oh.
And the murder took place in the photo's room.
In the bathroom. So it seems most likely that the killer must have taken her by surprise while she was in the bathroom. She didn't even have a chance to resist.
Huh? There's something odd about that last statement. It definitely contradicts what I already know. For this first debate, we'd like to take a quick sidebar. If you're unable to spot and refute someone's lies or contradictions, the argument will repeat. Within a group of statements, some words appear in a different color. Did you happen to notice? That represents a potential hole in a person's statement, a possible weak spot. These weak spots reveal important, though not always inaccurate, sections of a person's statement. Your truth bullets are only effective against those weak spots. So when you see one come up, take aim and fire, but only if you're sure it's actually wrong. Also, you can fast-forward an argument by hobbling down the B button. Well then, good luck and have fun! I let the arguments repeat every single time, so we can get all the dialogue.
And the murder took
in the bathroom, so it seemed the killer must have taken her by surprise while she didn't even have a chance to resist.
No, it's wrong!
Just a second, Chihiro. Try to remember how my room looked. With the way things had been damaged, I think we can definitely assume there was a struggle.
A struggle? Between who and who?
Between Sayaka and the killer, of course.
So you're saying Sayaka wasn't caught by surprise in the bathroom?
She must have been attacked in the main room first. Then she ran to the bathroom to try and hide. The killer followed her in, and that's where they finished the job.
That much should have been obvious after taking one look at the scene. It shouldn't even need explaining.
Sorry.
Okay, so what's next?
Next is the subject of the murder weapon.
Because I say so.
Wow, this is starting to sound like a real trial.
We need to determine what was used to kill Sayaka. Ishimaru's next to two dead people.
So what was used to kill her?
There was some kind of sharp object thrust into her stomach. Without a doubt, that is the murder weapon!
So the killer used some random knife they had on him. How could anyone do something like that? That son of a bitch!
Hold on, I feel like what I just heard is different from what I already know.
So what was used?
It was some kind of spell.
Without a doubt.
So the killer used some random knife.
No, that's wrong!
No. I do think it was a knife. But not just any knife.
This is
a
knife!
I'm positive it was a kitchen knife.
Huh? A kitchen knife?
After the murder, we discovered that one of the knives from the kitchen was missing.
Which means that knife must be the murder weapon.
Oh, yeah. I guess that makes sense. You could sorta see the weapon sticking out of her stomach.
Sorta? You could absolutely see it.
I could totally see that being a kitchen knife.
Okay, so the murder weapon was a kitchen knife, but where does that get us? I mean, we all know Makoto killed her, right?
That's right. Makoto's room was the scene of the crime. What more proof do you need?
Hold on a second.
Let's draw our conclusions after we presented our arguments. Otherwise, what's the point of the trial?
Well, we can talk all we want. It's not gonna change that conclusion.
I don't think that's true at all. I'm sure if we keep at it, something new will reveal itself.
You really believe that?
She's right. There's gotta be a breakthrough somewhere just waiting for us to find it. Because I know damn well I'm not the killer. There's a bit more to learn about non-stop debates. Would you like to hear more? You can concentrate by holding down the RB button. While you're concentrating, time will slow down and you can pay closer attention to what everyone's saying. On top of that, it'll steady your aim, making it easier to target potential weak spots. Concentrating like this consumes the focus gauge, and if the gauge empties, you can't concentrate. But the focus gauge will recover over time, so let your brain take a rest. No need to rush. Well then, good luck and have fun!
So I guess there's no question that the kitchen knife was the murder weapon. But where does that get us?
Makoto must have taken it from the kitchen, right? He did it in secret, when nobody was in the dining hall. And then he went and stabbed Sayaka with it!
So he really did do it!
Yes, and it's been decided. We've reached the end!
I didn't take the kitchen knife, but no matter how many times I repeat myself, you won't believe me. If only there were proof.
So I guess there's no question, but where does that...
Makoto must have did it in secret.
No, that's wrong!
Okay, wait. Hold on. I didn't take the knife from the kitchen.
Next, you're gonna say you're not the killer, right? Go ahead and say it all you want.
Well, what if I have a witness? What do you think, Tina?
Huh?
Remember what you were telling me earlier?
Well, I went to go get some tea from the kitchen last night, and all the knives were still there. But when I finished my tea and went back into the kitchen to wash my glass, one of the knives was gone. So you're saying the knife disappeared while you were drinking your tea in the dining hall? Yeah.
Just to be perfectly clear, the knife disappeared while you were in the dining hall, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
And at any point while you were there, did you ever see me come into the dining hall?
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No, he definitely wasn't there.
The knife disappeared while Kina was in the dining hall. But I wasn't there the entire time. In other words, there's no way I could have taken the knife.
Okay, then what about this? What if the idiot swimmer girl and Makoto are in on it together, and lying to protect each other?
idiot swimmer girl! Oh, and more importantly, why would I get involved in something like that?
Speaking of which, I'd like to ask the bear, if there is an accomplice, do they also become blackened?
So you ask, and so I shall answer. Each murder is allowed to have an accomplice, but only the one who does the killing will get to graduate.
So in other words, two people can work together, but one of them has no chance of profiting from it.
Then there's no way anyone would work together, right?
But what if they did work together, and they just didn't know about the rule?
Good grief! Enough already! No, okay? There are no accomplices in this case!
Oops! Did I say that out loud?
Anyway, I didn't go to the dining hall, and I didn't take the knife. So I'm not the killer!
Okay, so then, who did take the knife?
Hina seems the obvious candidate. After all, she just said she was in the dining hall.
No, no way! I swear it wasn't me!
Sure, but can you or anyone else prove that?
I can.
That's right! Sakura was with me the entire time I was drinking my tea.
I hate to have to ask, but just to be sure, Sakura's...
me.
Right.
But then, couldn't either one of them have grabbed the knife?
Actually, no. Because, well...
Just spit it out already.
I stayed in Hina's room last night.
I got so scared thanks to those creepy videos. I wasn't really thinking, I just asked her to stay over.
Which means, we have airtight alibis.
You stayed over? Doesn't that violate one of the school regulations?
We're not allowed to sleep anywhere but the dorms. But it doesn't say we have to stay in our assigned room. So, I don't think that's a problem.
It is a problem! A boy and a girl spending the night together? It's unwholesome!
But I'm a girl.
You are? Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry!
But if it wasn't either of you, then what other possibility is there?
Actually, there is one other possibility. Right, Hina?
Oh, yeah, that's true! One other person did come to the dining hall while we were there.
Why didn't you say so in the first place?
Well, because... they're not here anymore.
Someone who's not here? Are you talking about...
Sayaka. She's the one who came to the dining hall. And then later... she wound up dead.
Sayaka? Okay, so the person who took the knife from the kitchen was... they literally just said!
I got it!
But it does get way harder
then
later on.
Sayaka is the one who took the knife?
That's the only possibility.
I love her voice!
And thinking back on it, she was acting kind of unusual. When she came into the dining hall, she didn't even look at us. She just went straight to the kitchen.
It was so rude!
As she left, she said she just wanted a drink of water. But most likely...
and the person who took the knife was the victim herself!
I'm sure she just took it for self-defense.
So you're saying the knife she took was then taken from her, and she was killed with it? In that case, you may not have taken the knife, but you still could have killed her.
What?
See? He did do it after all!
No! You're wrong!
So, that's how you would twist the argument and send us all off in the wrong direction? You possess a most terrifying talent.
Damn, if I don't do something, they're gonna blame me for the murder. Don't they understand? If they convict me, everyone's gonna die!
Hold on. It's still too early to decide conclusively that Makoto is the killer, wouldn't you say? Because you see, if the room did belong to the killer, Then they did something most bewildering. And until we unravel that little mystery, you simply can't declare that he's the killer.
Bewildering? What the hell are you talking about?
Something was missing from the scene of the crime that by all rights should have been there. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Your first Hangman's Gambit is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Oh, I hate Hangman's Gambit. At least, as things advance further in a class trial, the Hangman's Gambit will eventually take place. The point of this is to reveal an important phrase related to the incident in question. You'll have to deduce the phrase from the letters flying around and the letters already known. Complete the phrase by shooting down the flying letters in the right order. Use the left stick to aim, then press the Y button to shoot the desired letters. If you shoot down the wrong letters, you'll suffer damage to your influence gauge. If this gauge reaches zero, or if you run out of time, you fail. Well then, good luck and have fun! Something that should have been at the scene, but wasn't. There must be a crucial point. That must be the crucial point. If we can just figure out what that something is... It's hair.
Right! There wasn't a single hair on the floor!
So, the culprit removed some evidence?
Yes. And if I were the culprit, why would I need to get rid of all the hair in my own room? It wouldn't be unusual at all to find my hair at the crime scene if the crime scene is in my room!
The reason all the hair was gone was to remove any trace that Sayaka had ever been there. That makes sense, does it not?
No. If that were the case, they would have had to do something about the body itself, not just her hair.
Ha ha ha! Yes, very true, very true!
Okay, then why wasn't there any hair on the ground?
The killer got rid of it all, of course, to remove any trace that they had ever been there.
Had ever been there.
Wait, then that means...
Precisely. It's simply beyond reason to believe that the room's owner and the killer are one and the same.
Then, Makoto isn't the culprit?
Are you sure we can decide something so important based solely on the absence of some hair?
No. There are other reasons that prove why Makoto couldn't have done it.
That smirk. I love her.
I would like to hear these reasons.
Do you remember anything remarkable about the bathroom at the scene?
There was a dead body in it. Case closed.
Sayaka was attacked in the main room first, then fled into the bathroom, right?
Yeah, then they ran after her, got into the bathroom, and stabbed her.
And how did the killer get into the bathroom? Did they have any trouble with it?
What do you mean?
It's fairly certain that the killer had some trouble getting into the bathroom. There was clear evidence left behind. Do you remember, Makoto?
The killer struggled getting into the bathroom, and the evidence that proves it...
I got it! Evidence that the killer had trouble getting into the bathroom. You're talking about the doorknob, right?
The doorknob? What doorknob?
The doorknob for my bathroom. It was completely broken. See how the top part was unscrewed? And the doorknob's about ready to fall off?
Oh yeah, true. But what does it mean?
In trying to bypass the lock, they ended up nearly removing the entire doorknob. This is another most bewildering act for the room's owner. It proves Makoto is beyond suspicion.
So what? You're saying he wouldn't break the door in his own room? But if the only choice you have is to break it, you break it. There's nothing bewildering about it.
You still don't see? Okay, then. Let's take another look at how the incident unfolded. Hopefully that will help you understand.
Kyoko said it was a bewildering act. I almost didn't notice it at first, but is that the key point here? There's a bit more to learn about non-stop debates. Would you like to hear more? From here on out, the number of weak spots will start going up. But no matter how many weak spots, there's essentially only one lie or contradiction in that debate. What I'm trying to say is not all weak spots you see are necessarily false. Use a truth bullet on the wrong one and not only will you fail to refute what they said, but you'll also lower your trust with everyone and your influence gauge will take damage. Now this is important because if your influence gauge reaches zero, you fail. You'll have to rely on your own logic to determine which weak spots are actually lies or contradictions. Well then, good luck and have fun!
The incident took place in Makoto's room. Sayaka was first attacked in the main room. She then fled into the bathroom.
Then the killer ran after her. And they got into the bathroom. At that point, the killer had to try and bust down the door. Because Sayaka had locked it.
And finally, the culprit had Sayaka cornered.
To finish the job, they stabbed her with the kitchen knife.
It was you, wasn't it, Makoto? Admit it! We already know the answer.
It's obvious that my bathroom door wouldn't open. But the real reason for that is...
The incident took place. Sayaka was first, she then fled into
the... Then the killer ran and they got into the bath. At that point, the killer...
Because Sayaka had walked...
No, that's wrong!
The reason my bathroom didn't open wasn't because it was locked. After all, the girls' rooms are the only ones with locking bathrooms, right?
Yes, now that you mention it, that is true.
Then why didn't your bathroom door open?
Because it was stuck.
Huh? What are you talking about?
My bathroom door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. Monokuma over there can testify to that.
Yep, true as true can be. But you know, you're supposed to be the ultimate lucky student, right? But to have such a cruddy door...
It's really not that big of a deal.
That's not lucky at all.
Unless you assigned him
the
room.
The reason the door didn't open was just because it was stuck. But the killer didn't know that and assumed it was locked. So they tore apart the doorknob to get in.
Okay, but then why would the killer even think the door was locked in the first place? Everyone should have known you can't lock any of the boys' bathrooms.
The killer could easily make that mistake, thanks to one important detail about the scene of the crime.
I love her, I love that smirk! One important detail. Something the killer didn't know. For some reason, they were convinced the door was locked. Which means the important detail the killer didn't know was...
I got it!
The killer must not have realized that it was my room.
What? Are you saying the culprit didn't even know where he was? That's inconceivable!
And yet, he's absolutely right.
Say what?
Well, to be more specific, what the killer didn't know was that Makoto and Sayaka had switched rooms. Which is what led to the misunderstanding about the bathroom. If Sayaka had been in her own room, then...
Then there would have been a lock on the door, and they would have had to break through!
So they had no idea how unnecessary their actions were.
Ultimately, we can't know if it came open by force or simply by accident. But... The killer must have been considerably confused, with no idea how they actually got the door opened.
Regardless, it was a pointless act. Wasting time trying to break down a door that wasn't locked is...
Definitely something I wouldn't do. since I would have known exactly why it wasn't opening, right?
That is a definite possibility.
So the killer would have to be someone who didn't know they'd switched rooms?
Then Makoto couldn't have done it.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Okay, then who did do it?
I'm sorry, but I give up! Quit without saving!
But what happens if we can't decide on who we think did it?
Well, why don't we just vote right now? Majority rules!
Majority rules? You really think that's a good idea?
That face.
Yeah, our necks are on the line here. Someone seriously needs to do something. For serious.
Seriously?
Does no one have any other thoughts or questions? It does not matter how trivial they may seem.
Oh, as a matter of fact, I do have one question.
Oh, you...
You don't gotta sound so disappointed.
It's fine, it's fine. Just ask your question.
Oh yeah. Okay, so... well... I was just wondering... How did the culprit get into Makoto's room in the first place?
Yes. How did the killer get inside?
Maybe Sayaka just dropped the key somewhere and the culprit picked it up. That's possible, right?
I don't think so. That seems way too convenient.
Then... maybe someone picked the lock?
Negative! If you remember, Monokuma made it quite clear that the locks are all unpickable.
Fine. How about this? The killer got in the easy way. They could have knocked and said they wanted to talk or something, and Ms. Maizono just let him in.
No, that can't be it either.
Oh-ho! Trying to argue against me? Sounds like someone doesn't know his place. Hello? Why exactly can't that be it?
Is he seriously shorter than Nagi? Oh my god. The reason there's no way Sayaka invited her killer into the room. I already have the answer.
I got it! Because Sayaka was already scared, remember? That's why she asked me to switch rooms in the first place.
The same goes for you, Sayaka. No matter who it is, don't open your door for anyone. Even if I'm sure it's you, I absolutely won't open it. Otherwise, what's the point of even switching?
Knowing what she'd been through, I just can't believe she would have opened the door for anyone.
What if her being scared was a lie?
Huh? Well, what the hell is that supposed to mean? Why would she lie about something like that?
I know you don't want to consider it. But look at this and tell me. Can you still deny the possibility?
There's something I want to talk to you about, just us two. In 5 minutes, come see me in my room. Check the nameplates to make sure you don't get the wrong room, okay?
I found a notepad during my search, and I shaded in the top sheet with a pencil. And these are the words that appear.
Oh man! I've totally seen people do that on detective shows. When you write, it can leave an imprint. Sketch over the next sheet of paper, and you can see the words. When I saw that, I was like, holy crap! I better make sure I rip the paper out before I use it from now on.
It's a pretty old-fashioned technique, but even the classics can be surprisingly useful sometimes. Oh, and I should also mention, I found the notepad on the desk in Makoto's room.
Huh?
Which means, only someone who had been in Makoto's room before the incident could have written it.
Then either it was Makoto who lived there, or Sayaka who switched rooms for a single night.
So, Makoto, did you write this?
It's signed Sayaka.
No, I didn't. But...
Of course you didn't. Because the note also bears a perfectly legible signature. Sayaka's signature.
Then that note... Sayaka wrote it?
But why? Why would she write that?
The note was likely her way of getting in touch with a certain someone. She must have slid it under their door to let them know she wanted to meet with them in secret.
If you got an invitation like that from the ultimate pop sensation, what young man could resist?
Of course, I'm only into 2D, so it wouldn't have any effect on me!
But can we be sure anyone even got this note? And honestly, even if they did, I do not think they are at all involved in what happened.
Huh? What makes you say that?
Would you like to hear what I have to say?
No.
Very well then.
Actually, yes, because you have a really nice voice.
Sayaka and Makoto switched rooms, correct? But in the note, the place they were asked to come to, it specifically says, my room.
I see. So if someone read that note, then they would have gone to Sayaka's room.
Exactly. The room that Makoto was staying in. So in other words, even if someone did read the note and did what it said, they would not have any connection to what happened.
Certainly would seem that way.
The reason the killer went to my room and not Sayaka's, despite what the note said, it must be because...
Sayaka and Makoto switched rooms, correct? But in the note, it specifically says, my...
I see. Then they would have gone exactly...
The room with Makoto.
No, it's wrong!
The nameplates on Mai and Sayaka's rooms got switched.
They got switched?
That's right. The nameplates got switched, just like the rooms themselves. As a result, the nameplate on Sayaka's room actually had Makoto's name. And the nameplate on Makoto's room had Sayaka's.
So what you're saying is, the room Sayaka was staying in was actually marked as her room.
Then, if someone did do what the note said, they would end up at Makoto's room where Sayaka was.
Plus, their rooms are right next to each other, so switching the nameplates would be no problem.
Alright, I just looked this up. This is really cool. Erica Harlicher is the voice for, Kirigiri in this, and apparently she's only been voice acting. She's 26, but she's only been voice acting since 2011, and she's only done a few things so far, but she was actually... She wanted to be a voice actress ever since she was little, and she actually is a big anime fan, and she went to Anime Expo, and she attended workshops. And I think that's really cool and really inspiring, because that represents a lot of us young voice actors right now.
And the one who switched the names was... Well, of course it wasn't you. Right, Makoto?
Sorry to stop like that. I just find that really interesting.
Okay, then who did
Like, it? I never heard her before. There's only one person who could have switched the nameplates.
I got it!
Me and Sayaka were the only ones who ever knew about us switching rooms. So the only other person besides me who would even know to switch the nameplates was Sayaka.
You can also infer as much from her note.
There's something I want to talk to you about, just us two. In 5 minutes, come see me in my room. Check the nameplates to make sure you don't get the wrong room, okay?
She specifically tells the reader to check the nameplate. She would only have written that if she knew the nameplates had been switched.
But why would she switch them in the first place?
She wanted someone to come to the room she was in, and also hide the fact that it was Makoto's room.
What?
Inviting someone to your room, but not telling them you'd switched rooms. Why would anyone do that?
To understand that, we first need to understand what happened after she invited the person into the room. That's where the answer lies.
What happened then was probably whoever she invited over came in and attacked her. We figured it out! We know who did it! Whoever she invited over is the culprit!
But we still don't know who it is, you goddamn idiot!
Sayaka fought with her killer there in the room, yes? Perhaps the answer to our previous question lies in that initial struggle.
Yes, I think you're right.
Then... we just have to figure out what happened during the fight, right?
That reminds me. There was a replica sword at the murder scene. Was that perhaps used during the fight?
Oh yeah. What's the deal with that sword?
Sayaka suggested I should hold on to it. I thought it might come in handy if I had to defend myself. It seems pretty likely that the killer used it to break Sayaka's right wrist.
How the hell could you possibly know that's what broke her wrist?
The reason I know Sayaka's wrist was broken with the fake sword is because...
I got it!
All you have to do is take a good look at her broken wrist, and it should become pretty clear.
Hey everyone, let's go take a good look at Sayaka's broken
right
wrist.
Right there where her wrist is all swollen. There's something glittery there. See?
Is that gold?
It sure is. Specifically, the gold coating from the replica sword. You barely have to touch that stuff, and it'll stick right to you. And there's some on her wrist because...
I got it! Because she got hit with the sword! Right there on her wrist!
Aw, I was gonna say that.
I see, I see. And so the truth draws ever closer.
Alright, then it's about time to solve this mystery.
And what led to Sayaka? Sorry. I was looking at my phone. I should probably put it down. There's a bit more to learn about non-stop debates. Would you like to hear more? Are you getting used to these non-stop debates? Starting with the next debate, I'll start loading multiple truth bullets into your truth cylinder. No, don't do that. But just like with the weak spots, only one of those bullets can actually refute the proper statement. In other words, from here on out, you'll have to combine the right truth bullets with the right weak spots to refute each statement. It shouldn't be this easy from the beginning because I have the difficulty set to mean. If you come up with the wrong combination, you'll take damage to your influence gauge. You can press the LB button to rotate the cylinder and choose which bullet to fire. Press and release the LB button to cycle through each bullet. Or you can hold down the LB button, then use the left stick to select a specific bullet. By the way, if the logic difficulty is set to kind, fewer bullets will be loaded into the cylinder. For our purposes, this time the logic difficulty will be set to mean. Because I have set to that anyway. Well then, good luck and have fun!
When the fighting broke out, the culprit grabbed the sword. And that's when the first blow was dealt. Sword-based sneak attack!
And that's what broke Ms. Maizono's wrist!
So, she tried to fight back. She grabbed the kitchen knife she had hidden away. But then the culprit took that from her too.
And they killed her with it.
And that's exactly what happened.
The sword was used first, and then the knife came afterwards. Is that really the order of events? That leads to some unexplainable details.
When the fighting broke out,
the culprit...
And that's when the first sword-based sneak attack!
No, it's wrong!
Actually, no. I don't think the fight started with the sword.
Why not?
Because the sword sheath had been scratched. See? There's a gash in it. Like someone cut into it with something sharp.
Something sharp? You mean like the kitchen knife? That was the only sharp thing found at the scene.
Stop jumping ahead! Slow down and explain it so I get what the hell's going on.
If the sword was used first, there wouldn't be any explanation for the scratch on the sheath. If you were going to attack with the sword, you'd take it out of the sheath first, right?
That's true. With the sheath on, it'd be heavy and bulky and useless as shit.
Okay, so how did the sheath get damaged?
If they got attacked with the kitchen knife, maybe they grabbed the sword as a defensive impulse. In that situation, there wouldn't be any time to actually unsheath the sword.
So you're saying the sword was initially used to defend against an attack from the knife?
Which means whoever had the kitchen knife was the one who attacked first.
I think I get it. So here's how it all played out. The culprit came in, found the kitchen knife hidden there somewhere. Then they took the knife and attacked Sayaka before she knew what was happening. So she grabbed the sword to defend herself, but then the culprit took that from her too. Then, after they broke her wrist with the sword, they took the knife and finished it.
Sorry, but I don't think Sayaka used the sword to defend herself.
What? How the hell can you not think that?
Because she never held the sword at all. There's a certain part of her body that makes this clear.
The part of her body that shows she never used the sword.
I got it!
You're talking about her palms, right? The palms of her hands were perfectly clean. So I don't think she ever picked up the sword.
How can you know that just by looking at her palms?
Like I said before, the gold coating on that sword comes right off. All you have to do is touch it. In fact, if you look, you'll notice that a lot of the gold has already come off the handle. It's safe to assume that's because whoever used the sword got some of it on their hands. There's really no way she could have picked it up and come away completely clean.
Maybe she washed her hands after she escaped into the bathroom.
Sorry, but I don't think so.
Why do you say that? Is it because you think I'm ugly?
No, that's not it at all.
There's no way Sayaka washed the gold coating off of her hands because she's afraid of water.
I got it!
According to the Monokuma file, Sayaka's time of death was around 1:30 a.m. In other words, at nighttime. And the water in the bathroom shuts off at nighttime, right?
Oh, I didn't know that. Actually, I haven't taken a shower.
Oh my.
You're no different! You smell like a big, fat, ugly donkey!
Hmm? I'm not sure whether to take that as an insult or a compliment.
Insult, obviously.
So anyway, if Sayaka never touched the sword, then that means the killer is the only one who used the sword. But hold on. If that's right, then the one who damaged the sheath with the kitchen knife was...
The one who damaged the sheath would have had to be the one without the sword.
I got it!
Sayaka? She had the kitchen knife?
But we already said that the attack started with...
The person with the knife attacked first, and the sword was used as an impromptu defense.
Then the one who attacked first was...
Sayaka?
Now do you understand? She wasn't a blameless victim in this.
No, far from it. It's almost as if she'd been planning to commit a murder of her own.
What?
She took the knife from the kitchen, then invited the culprit to the room she was staying in. And if it's true that she had the kitchen knife and attacked without provocation...
Indeed. These are all the actions of an assailant.
Which brings up another point. Makoto. Sayaka was the one who suggested you two switch rooms, correct? Maybe the reason she wanted to switch rooms... was so that she could pin the crime on you. That is a possibility, is it not?
Sayaka wanted to... on me?
Sayaka wanted to on me!
That would also explain why she would switch the nameplates. She wanted to get whoever she had targeted to come to Makoto's room where she was staying. And by committing the murder there, instead of her room, that would implicate Makoto. But for that to work, the target had to be lured out while still keeping the room swap a secret. If the target knew she had switched rooms, they would have become suspicious right away.
So all that's why she switched the names?
Doesn't that seem a little risky?
Even if her plan worked, Mr. Naegi would just tell everyone they'd switched rooms.
I don't know. I'm not sure our soft-hearted Makoto is capable of that kind of cutthroat behavior.
But you were suspecting
I'm sure
him earlier.
Sayaka realized the same thing, which is why out of all of us, she asked him to switch rooms.
Plus, she was the ultimate pop sensation. A totally forgettable kid. Or a national superstar. Who are you more likely to believe?
Wait, then... you're saying she had this all planned out?
Holy shit!
But in the end, her plan backfired. She launched her attack with the knife, then found herself under attack in turn. That must be when her wrist got broken, and she was forced to drop the knife.
The tables were suddenly turned on her, and
the
she
tables
died at the
had
hands
tables.
Of the one she planned to murder.
Just hold on! That can't be true! Because...
Hey! Hey! You guys have totally derailed the argument! You're being super boring right now! Come on, hurry up and decide who did it! Wouldn't it be awful if I had to punish you all just because you ran out of time?
Oh yeah, we gotta decide who we think did it.
Makoto. Right now, you just need to concentrate on figuring out the answer to this mystery. If we can't uncover who murdered Sayaka, it's over for all of us.
All you need to do is decide the killer. It's so simple. Is it really all over? Obviously, I'm committed to finding out who killed her, but what can I do? I mean, as far as clues go, there's nothing left.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide who did it. But there just aren't any more clues, right?
Very well. Then let's review all the clues we've found up to this point one more time.
Do we really have time for all that?
Die! Die! If we don't do something, we're all gonna die!
She likes playing Reaper. Die. Die. Wait, no, hold on. That's right, there is still a clue left that can lead us to who killed her. Sayaka left it behind.
It's easy just to say, hey, decide who did it. But there just aren't any more clues, right?
No, that's wrong! There still might be one clue left. Sayaka's dying message.
Dining? Wait, what did you
dining
say?
Dining message.
The dying message. She wrote something on the wall behind her, remember? 11037. Written in her own blood. There must be a clue about the killer hidden in there.
Well, before we get too far into that, I need to ask, can we really be sure that Sayaka is the one who wrote it?
There's no question that Sayaka wrote that message, and I can prove it.
I got it! Her left index finger had blood on it. That could only be because she used that finger to write the message.
I see. She broke her right wrist during the fight, so she'd have to use her left hand to write.
Sure. I think we can all agree Sayaka wrote it. But still, what the heck do those numbers mean? 11037?
Hey, Chihiro. You're a computer nerd or whatever, right? You should know all about numbers and shit.
No, that's not... Yes, I'm a programmer, but I don't see any kind of meaning in these numbers.
Of course. It's because they're not numbers.
If we assign them to a letter, it would be...
Yeah, it looks like...
Oh, wait, there's no zero. What?
No, it's just... look at the numbers, assuming they're not numbers. Don't these first two, 1-1, look less like two numbers and more like one letter?
Ah, you're right. The connecting line is barely there, so I assumed it was 1-1, but looking at it now, you could also read it as an N.
She's Japanese. Whoa. Why would she write it in the Roman alphabet?
My little gray cells are really getting excited now.
But even if
I guess
really
Leon would be
N037
katakana,
doesn't make
so
any
then...
more sense than before.
Damn it, it's no use. I just don't know. It's Noelle. Christmas killed her.
Rotate the image 180 degrees.
Huh? Rotate it? I think maybe. Maybe I see something. No, I think Noelle is the answer.
Oh,
Christmas killed her.
Now I see. She wrote down the killer's name.
Huh? You just shot past the clue part and right onto who did it.
So, whose name did she write?
Sayaka's dying message reveals the real killer's name. You could turn your Vita upside down, but not your computer. Well, I guess you could if you had a laptop. Or just really wanted to turn your monitor upside down.
Here's my answer! The key to solving this mystery was simply to rotate the writing 180 degrees. If you turn the message around, it becomes the letters L-E-O-N. L-E-O-N. Or more accurately, Leon.
What the hell are you talking about? It's just a coincidence. It's just a bunch of random squiggles that happen to look like my name.
No, it's not random at all. She wrote that message on the wall behind her as she was leaning up against it. In that position, she couldn't move to write normally, and had to write upside down, as it were. And as a result, when you look at it standing in front of her, it ends up getting flipped. Try it for yourself if you want. Write something sitting like her, and the letters will be inverted.
That sounds like one hell of a stretch to me. I'm the killer? You can't just go and say shit like that.
If you're not the killer, then why did you try to destroy the evidence?
Huh?
You know what I'm talking about, right, Makoto? The evidence Leon tried to get rid of?
How do you know that I know that? The evidence that Leon tried to get rid of, I know what it was.
I got it! You mean... the burnt shirt piece I found laying on the ground by the incinerator, right?
As the killer stabbed Sayaka, they must have gotten some of her blood on them. And to dispose of the shirt covered in the victim's blood, they threw it into the incinerator.
But one piece burned off and got left behind.
And the killer didn't notice. If they had, they most certainly would have panicked. Isn't that right, Leon?
But is one scrap of fabric enough to conclude that Leon is guilty?
Yes!
No, I mean, Leon's not the only one wearing a white button-up.
That's right! There are plenty of other people here with shirts like mine. With just that one little charred piece, there's no way you can say for sure who it belongs to.
You're right. That alone isn't enough. But there are some other points that may reveal the truth.
Are you finally starting to understand?
The answers to all the riddles are right here.
Yeah, I think so.
The burnt remains of the button-up shirt, which the killer wasn't able to get rid of. There's something about it we need to pay attention to in order to figure out who's responsible. I mean, where and how could be the same thing. It could be the exact same thing.
I got it!
If you look closely at how the shirt was disposed of, we should be able to figure out who the killer is.
Oh yeah, that's a good point. I think I know what you're gonna say. You can't reach the incinerator without opening the gate in front of the trash room, right? And obviously, you wouldn't be able to hit the switch to turn it on, either. You'd need the key to get in, and the one with the key was the person on cleaning duty. So the killer had to be whoever was in charge of taking care of the trash, right?
Interesting.
No, that's wrong. There was another way to use the incinerator without being the one on cleaning duty. And that's exactly what proves that Leon is the real killer.
The key to the trash room. Whoever was on cleaning duty must have had it, right?
So the only one who could get to the incinerator was the person in charge of the trash?
And you'd have to get close to the incinerator in order to destroy the evidence. Which means the only possible suspect is whoever had the trash room key.
Okay, so the person who would have had the trash room key was... Huh? Me? No!
Is it really impossible to have destroyed evidence without the trash room key? No, I'm sure there was another way.
The key to the whoever was on click,
so the only one was...
And you'd have to get close to the incinerator.
No, that's wrong. Hold on. I think I know how someone could dispose of the evidence without using the trash room key.
But if you can't get past the gate, you couldn't possibly turn on the incinerator, could you?
Yes, you could. If you used this.
What is it, some kind of glass ball? It's busted to hell.
How could you tell that just from the...
Actually, it was supposed to be a crystal ball, but,
But how would you use it?
The killer had to use the glass ball in a certain way, which was...
I got it!
Divine with it.
The killer simply took aim at the incinerator switch and threw the ball through a gap in the gate. All they had to do was hit that switch, and the incinerator would come to life.
Someone threw that through a gap in the gate?
Remember what you said before, Hifumi?
Huh? Someone turned the incinerator on? Very strange. I'm quite certain it was off last time I was down here. Perhaps it was the work of a fairy.
Hifumi had the key. So the only way the incinerator could have been turned on without his knowledge was because the killer was able to hit the switch without opening the gate. Once they'd gotten the incinerator going, all they had to do was ball up the shirt and toss it in.
Hey, come on! What the hell is this?
All you have to do is look at the scene to know that the killer never actually went inside the trash room. The shards of broken glass, the incinerator left running, the piece of shirt that escaped the fire. If the killer had been on cleaning duty, the evidence would have been taken care of much more thoroughly.
Wait, no, just hold on.
But the distance from the gate to the incinerator has to be at least 30 feet, right? The pinpoint accuracy you'd need to throw a glass ball that far and hit something that small.
Could someone really do that?
That's right! There's no way! It'd be impossible!
Difficult, absolutely. Impossible? I don't think so. Because the killer is...
It wouldn't have been much of a challenge at all for the killer, because...
I got it!
Because the killer is the ultimate baseball star!
Isn't that right, Leon? Do you have any idea how stupid you sound?
If that is
right
your
now?
Real name, which it probably isn't.
A target 30 feet away would surely be little challenge for the ultimate baseball star.
You can't be serious. I'm not the killer. These goddamn shipper brains have got it all wrong, I'm telling you.
You still won't admit it? Okay, then. Makoto, go ahead and review the incident one more time to make his crime perfectly clear. And with that, we can end this.
Listen to me! What the hell do you mean, end this?
Say what you want, Leon. But all the questions have been answered, and the truth has been revealed. Now here's what happened.
The closing argument is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Every case has one last element to bring the class trial to an end. This is the closing argument. In this phase, you'll give a complete summary of the case. You'll have to reproduce the flow of events from the case in the form of a comic book. However, you'll notice that in the comic, there are a number of pieces missing. It's up to you to complete the comic using the provided truth panels. Also, if you take aim at a missing section and press the A button, holy cow, you'll get a hint that might lead to a breakthrough. Well then, good luck and have fun. This is a little hard in the first game because you can't tell what's going on. My room was the scene of the crime. The incident began when the killer entered. First, when Sayaka attacked the killer with the knife, they noticed something in my room. They used that object to deflect Sayaka's attack, which is why that evidence was damaged. That evidence? After the killer countered Sayaka's attack with an attack of their own, what did they do next? They forced the bathroom door open. The only logical way they could have done that was... After she was stabbed, Sayaka used the last of her strength to leave something behind. The killer used an item in my room to help dispose of evidence. The object the killer threw to activate the incinerator must have been... killer threw in the incinerator was... the piece of evidence left behind in the trash room.
The killer is... you! I think I'd better take one more look back at the case from the beginning. Last night, the killer went to the room Sayaka was in. In other words, my room. From what we can tell, Sayaka invited that person there intending to kill them. She attacked them with the knife she'd taken from the kitchen earlier. But then something happened that she wasn't prepared for. They grabbed the fake sword I put in my room, and fought back. During the struggle, A strike from the sword broke Sayaka's right wrist. And that's when she lost her grip on the kitchen knife. Finding herself cornered, Sayaka panicked and ran into the bathroom. The killer went after her, but couldn't get the bathroom door open. What they didn't know was that my bathroom door got stuck easily, and there was a trick to opening it. Sayaka knew about that because I told her, but of course the killer had no way of knowing. So instead, the killer forced the door open, took the kitchen knife, and stabbed Sayaka. But with what strength she had remaining, Sayaka left a dying message. To keep the killer from noticing, she wrote it on the wall behind her. And with that, all her strength was gone. With Sayaka dead, the killer quickly began destroying the evidence. First, they took off their shirt, which was covered in their victim's blood. Then they took the lint roller in my room and cleaned up the entire area. They wanted to make sure they got rid of any trace they'd ever been there. Afterwards, the killer headed to the trash room to destroy their bloody shirt. They tried to burn the shirt using the incinerator there. But the trash room was blocked off by an especially sturdy gate, preventing access to the incinerator. So they came up with a plan to use Hiro's crystal ball, which he'd left in the laundry room. The killer managed to throw the ball through the gap in the gate and hit the incinerator switch. For any normal person, that'd be an impossible throw, but the killer had the confidence to take a shot. And that's because the killer was the ultimate baseball star.
Wait, we knew that already.
The crystal ball, thrown with absolute precision, hit the switch on the incinerator, which then quickly roared to life. Having destroyed the final piece of evidence, they left the area with, I imagine, a sigh of relief.
Stop assuming things.
But there was one thing they missed. Part of the shirt they'd thrown into the fire burnt away and fell out of the incinerator. The killer didn't notice this, and so left behind a piece of indisputable evidence.
I mean, it was disputable since you didn't originally know what kind of...
Isn't that right, Leon? It would appear that Hiro simply forgot his crystal ball in the laundry room. You went there to try and wash the blood out of your shirt, and that's where you saw it, right? Seeing the ball, you thought of a way to take care of everything.
So, Leon, do you object to anything that's been said?
Do I object? Hell yes, I object! Of course I do! I object, I object, I object! I mean, all of this is just a bunch of stupid theories! You need evidence! Where's the evidence? Without evidence, it's all bullshit! It's bullshit and I refuse to acknowledge it!
Well then, I guess this is as good a time as any to present the evidence that proves you did it. Makoto, I believe you're in possession of that evidence.
I have the evidence? Your first bullet time battle is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Sometimes, during a class trial, your opponent simply won't want to hear what you have to say. When this happens, you will engage them in a head-to-head battle. We like to refer to this as the bullet time battle, aka the BTB, by the way. During the bullet time battle, you'll want to destroy your opponent's statements in time with the rhythm. Match your button presses with each tempo marker as they move across the screen and reach the center. Press the A button to lock onto an opponent's statement. Destroy the statement you've locked on to with the Y button as the tempo marker reaches the center. Use the method to deal damage to your opponent. If you can't pull it off, you'll be the one in pain. Do this consecutively and you'll start a combo. Keep this going and you'll initiate a tempo up. On the flip side, if you keep missing, you'll get into a tempo down situation. When the tempo changes, so does the timing for hitting each button. So watch out for that! Deal enough damage to your opponent and the weak spot statement will appear. At that point, you can press the Y button to shoot it down with a truth bullet like any other statement. Refute their statements fast enough and you'll come out victorious. But just like before, if your influence gauge reaches zero or you run out of time, you fail. Well then, good luck and have fun! Oh, I'm really bad at this. I'm good at rhythm games, I play Project Diva on Hard and Expert, but I'm really bad at this. It's broken, it's the game's fault. What did the killer use to take apart the doorknob?
I refuse to acknowledge you! You're stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid! Stupid, 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 stupid!
You're really making a good argument now, Leon. I have to show indisputable evidence that Leon is the killer. I need to figure it out. It's like...
Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid! You lie! Shut up!
See, it's on the downbeat now. It's like...
You kidding me? Not a chance! You lie! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance! It wasn't me! Stupid! You lie! Shut up! Where's your proof? You kidding me? Not a chance!
Yeah, it's like on the downbeat, and then it's not on the downbeat, and then it is.
This should prove it.
The screws on the bathroom doorknob were removed. I wonder what kind of tool the killer used to remove them.
I mean, it had to be a screwdriver, right?
Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure the toolkits we got each had one inside.
And that must be what he used. There aren't any other tools anywhere.
But the toolkit in my room had clearly never been used.
That's because the culprit didn't know it was your room. They thought they were in Sayaka's room.
Only the boys got toolkits, so the killer naturally assumed there wouldn't be one in there.
Okay, then whose toolkit did the killer use?
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
It had to be their very own toolkit.
Stupid, 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 stupid!
Leon, would you mind showing us your toolkit? If I'm right about this, then the screwdriver will show some evidence of being used.
Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Huh? And if you say you used it for something else, you'll have to explain exactly when, where, and why.
And let me say this right now. I lost it isn't an excuse at this point.
Stupid. Stupid.
So, you have no rebuttal?
Then it would seem we are finished here.
Thank you.
Looks like you've reached your verdict. Then are we ready to cast our votes? You all have a lever in front of you. Use it to make your selection.
Wait, so there's 15 levers?
Just to remind you all, make triple sure you vote for someone. You wouldn't want to be punished for something so minor, right? Okay, then let's get excited! Who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Uh-oh, looks like you got it right on the money! The blackened in this case, the one that killed Sayaka, was none other than Leon Kuwata!
Huh? Hey, hold on!
Leon, did you really kill Sayaka?
But
I don't believe it!
You son of a bitch!
What the hell is wrong with you?
I didn't have a choice.
It was kill or be killed.
So, that's why...
I killed her first.
None of you are any different!
One wrong step and you'd be the one standing here. It was complete chance that I wound up like this.
I was just... unlucky. That's all. Hey! Come on!
You expect me to just accept my death?
Everything's become clear. The decision we made was right after all. But when I think about that, honestly, I'd be better off if we'd been wrong. Because if what we came up with is really the truth, then that truth is that Sayaka was trying to frame me. But even if that's true, I can't say she was wrong. After all, the mastermind... it's all because of that video. Even I couldn't handle what I saw in there. If I was her and that video actually had something to do with me, I can't even imagine.
Now we're trapped here with no way out! They're probably waiting for me! Why? Why? I can't afford to be stuck in here!
The one thing that was more important to her than anything else, her dreams, her friends. To have to see something like that happen to them, and Sayaka...
I did whatever it took to reach that dream. I mean it. Even some things that weren't so pleasant.
And that's why Sayaka, for the friends that meant so much to her, that's why she betrayed me. So when she said...
No matter what happens, please always be there for me. I need you on my side.
She was lying to me from the very beginning. She was using me. Is that why she talked to me in the first place? I guess I'll never know. Because there's nothing I can do to ask her what she was thinking. Once you're dead, that's that.
Boy, howdy! The entertainment industry must sure be terrifying, huh? I mean, to try and kill someone just because of those relationships.
Ba-bum, ba-bum.
She seemed so nice and lovely on the outside, but inside, she descended into pure madness!
What did you say?
I understand, really I do. Yep. You're in utter despair thanks to Sayaka's betrayal, right? Compassion, intimacy, love. The stronger those feelings, the stronger the despair when they collapse.
Stop screwing with us. This is all your fault.
Sayaka being forced to do something like that. All of it. Everything. It's all your fault. Suddenly, in a frenzy, I lunged at Monokuma. But...
That's enough.
As angry as I would... was, Kyoko latched onto my arm without hesitation. Her grip was like iron, strong enough I was sure it would leave a bruise.
Calm down.
If you really want to make her enemies pay for what they've done, you need to let it go for now.
Damn it.
Ba-bum,
Baba.
Ah, that was a close one. I thought for sure you were gonna give me a good walloping. Just barely avoided punishment, you did.
Yes, indeed.
Now then, since you so magnificently revealed the identity of the killer during the class trial, the blackened Leon Kuwata will receive his punishment.
Punishment? You mean execution?
Wait a second!
I didn't have a choice. I had to kill her.
Yeah, that's it.
I was just protecting myself in the heat of the moment. It was self-defense.
Is that okay?
How exactly was it self-defense? When you forced your way into the bathroom, did you or did you not use your very own toolkit? After she'd shut herself in the bathroom, you went out of your way to head back to your own room. Then you came all the way back, broke into the bathroom, and killed her. Am I wrong?
Do you understand?
You had any number of chances to stop what you were doing, but you chose not to. Is it not because you had an unclouded intent to commit murder?
So...
God, I love
that's
Celeste.
Why...
That's not... Stop it. I've had enough of this.
Oh.
Are you sure? You were closer to her than anyone, were you not? He killed your precious Sayaka. Do you understand?
I can't say Leon is solely to blame. Of course, I don't plan on blaming Sayaka either. Because the one to blame is him.
Huh?
What? If it weren't for you, this never would have happened to Sayaka or Leon. We shouldn't be fighting each other. We should be fighting against the one who put us in this situation, the mastermind. Did you awaken to your sense of justice?
Hey!
Well, it just so happens that there's nothing more unethical than an unwavering sense of justice. After all, it's people with that sort of mentality that perpetuate war all over the world.
Hmm.
Is that the kind of justice that's awakened within you? Just shut up!
Hmm.
Okay, well, anyway, more importantly,
let's hurry up and
get to what everyone's been waiting for! The punishment!
I'm begging you! Please! Don't do this!
Hey!
No more begging! No more excuses! You must pay the penalty for breaking the rules! Society demands it!
Stop! Please!
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment!
For Leon Kuwata, the ultimate baseball star!
No!
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
No!
What we saw, that was the true face of despair. I mean, if we can't call it that, what else could we call it? It had a title! The 1,000 Blows.
Woohoo! Man, my adrenaline is pumping right out of control! What's going on?
I can't take it.
Do we really have to keep doing this? I just can't take it.
Well, hey, if you don't like it... All you gotta do is swear to cut all ties with the outside world and accept living here forever. But that's only if every single one of you can get on board with that.
Damn you!
Fuck you. Why the fuck are you doing this evil shit to us?
What the heck?
Evil? You make it sound like I'm some dark, awful secret society type of guy.
Say what?
Or in this case, a dark, awful secret society type of bear. So why are you putting an upstanding young citizen like me through such a grueling ordeal?
Hey,
it seems like you're trying to use common sense to make sense of sense of something that doesn't make sense. That's like trying to put a mile on a scale. I just don't think it's possible. I don't think what you're saying and what I'm saying quite fit together.
Dude,
you piece of shit. I don't know who you are, but I'm gonna pound your ass into the ground.
You must really hate me to get so angry, huh? But if you do that, you're barking way up the wrong tree. What happened, happened because more than one of you decided you wanted to get out, right? No matter how much time passes, you can't cut free of your regrets from the outside world. You're to blame.
Of course we can't cut free of the outside world. Being trapped in this insane place?
You're trapped, are you? Well, I'm sure once you learn all the mysteries of this school, your thinking will change for sure. You'll think, boy, isn't it so wonderful how we all get to live here forever?
What does this mean?
What are you trying to say?
Hey,
I feel like there's some deeper meaning hidden in there. Just like before.
Chills! Chills! Kills!
Anyway, let's get to the Blackened punishment. That's what everyone is waiting for, after all!
Hey.
When you say everyone, who exactly are you referring to?
Sorry, I said everything I've gotta say! I need to save some of the fun for later!
And just like that, he was gone. He left us there, overwhelmed by a nightmare turned to reality. Even after he was gone, we stood there forever, unable to move. Actually, no, it wasn't that long, I think. Everyone just lost their sense of time. We were all too scared. Scared of being alone. No one even tried to speak. Their faces were stone, their voices dead. But it was in that moment.
Just a second.
Makoto, can I talk to you for a second? She moved in close and whispered into my ear.
Makoto.
Before we head back, there's something I want to talk to you about. It's about Sayaka, isn't it? I'm surprised you figured it out.
Listen.
I told you before the class trial started. You had to figure out the mystery of this case yourself. You wanted me to realize how Sayaka betrayed me by myself, didn't you? The thought never even crossed my mind. I feel like such a fool becoming such an easy target like that.
It's true.
Sayaka meant to double-cross you. That's a fact that you can never change. But even till the very end, she wasn't sure of her decision. That's why, as she lay dying, she was thinking of you. She was thinking of me? You can't just say something like that. I mean, there's no way you can know that. Only Sayaka would know for sure, and we can't ask her now.
However...
Even if you can't ask her, you can infer it, don't you think? Her final thought was how she could protect you. What?
So...
The fact that she used her last ounce of energy to leave her dying message proves it. If she didn't care what happened to you, she never would have left that message. Well, maybe she just wanted to get back at the person who had killed her.
Certainly.
That's certainly one possibility. But I don't think that's what it was.
Anyway...
She was uncertain. She wasn't sure if she should kill someone, or deceive you. Which is why her plan failed. Her hesitation attracted failure.
Right.
It's almost ironic when you think about it. Why are you telling me all this? Because you're the kind of person who can overcome this. Because you can move past the deaths of your friends, Sayaka and Leon, and keep moving forward.
Correct.
Without someone like that, the others would never be able to break free of such a desperate situation. Move past their deaths? I could never do that. No. I'm going to carry them with me the rest of my life. How could I possibly move past something like that? Leon, Sayaka, I'll carry them with me forever. I'll carry their memories with me wherever I go. So instead of forgetting them, you're choosing the hard road. Well, I have high expectations for you. As she said that, she revealed the smallest smile.
Hey.
By the way, I have to admit, I'm curious. How did you know I wanted to talk to you about Sayaka? Oh, well... I'm psychic.
What?
Kidding. I just have pretty good intuition. He received the Despair Bat present.